In the first-hand rock, you can find the access to the intelligence archives. The problem is that it is locked by three dial codes. The first can be found on the table you will see on the right. The next steps requires you to be in the morning. If you aren't, you have to skip the time. In the same room between the code knot and the door, you will find a radio. Hack it in order to hear a special message. In case you don't hear it, you have to go in the audio options and decrease to zero the music and SFX. Now apply the settings and hack the radio again and you will hear a message. It will say a coordinate followed by a number. And this will be done for three different locations. The coordinates will be the same for every playthrough, while the second number will be different. So, after you hear the M13, you have to sign down the number you hear next.
M13, 10.
Followed by H26 and its number as well.
H26, 13.
To finish with the R33 followed by its number.
R33, 15.
Now that you are signed every number, it's time to go back to your safe house. Skip the day to the next morning and get to the Updam region, where after exiting the safe house you need to turn to the right and use the mountain ramp to get to the left roof. From here you have to jump to the fence and cross over it. Now staying on the right, reach the staircase going down, where you have to use the terrain ramp on the left in order to reach the next roof. This will lead you in front of your apartment window. Now jump down to the left and follow the electrical cables until you reach the Otto's workshop, on the left from which you can access another building. Go upstairs until you will reach an apartment entrance with the doorbell. Now you need to check the number you sign it after H26 code.
H26, 13.
This is the right amount of times you have to press the doorbell in order to open the door. In this apartment, on the right, above a drawer, you will notice a weapon. That is an epic shotgun you can take. Now destroy the colored glass you will notice on the right in order to access the next room, where on the whiteboard you can find a lot of discoveries you will need later on. Now check on the right in order to find the Alexis in the Row Part 1 document with another note. The last one has the code you need. Now go back to your safe house and skip another day. This is because you need to reach the Carl's Bay also during the morning, where you have to use the main road going to the right all the way till the red house, where at the beginning of it you have to enter inside the building. Now follow the corridor to the right until you will reach a building with a huge gear, on the right of which you can notice another doorbell. The amount of time you have to press it is the same signed after the M30 in the radio message.
M13, 10.
Now going upstairs on the box you will notice another document. While turning around on the pillows you will find the note that have the third code. For an extra on the left upside a box you will find another note, and more to the left on the ground you will find other two notes with some discoveries. To finish, on the right of the door you will notice also an epic Nile gun. Now it's time to skip the day again in order to go to the Carl's Bay during the morning, where staying on the left you will find a bunker with a barred door. Destroy the wooden wall in order to reveal the entrance inside with the doorbell on the left. The number after the R33 code in the radio message is the amount of time you need to press the doorbell in order to open the access inside this room.
R33, 15.
Where you will find again the intelligence archive access. Now in the DL1 insert the code you found in the freestand rock. In the DL2 insert the code you found in the Updam. While in the DL3 insert the code you found in the Carl's Bay. Once opening the archive secret door, you have to go all the way at the end, where on the right in the safe you'll find two Founder's pistols. You can equip both in order to have the dual version. Near the safe you will find the first note to collect in this area. Then on the left you will find other five notes on the whiteboard that have several secret codes in order to save some time, including the delivery booth and the hangar too. Also, while exiting, don't forget to check between the libraries, because upside a box you will find another note to read.